Kingsman.
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 So we just saw Kingsman, the Golden Circle. And
all right, we need to start over.
Yeah, that was so bad.
Fucking Allie, yeah, I hear you laughing in the background.
Alejandro just started like randomly. So
this is messy.
Starting over.
Bring it home.
Starting over.
God damn it! You made it worse. You made it worse by going like silent, just going.
It's my Robert De Niro.
Is it?
Anyways,
Kingsman. Now we're really red, and we can talk about
yeah,
Kingsman.
Now we're really red. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Right. What's general overall feelings?
Overall
over
feelings.
General, like lump sum.
Yeah. Super, super generalized feeling. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You know, okay. It just kind of boils down to, without saying too much, something that I probably wish I didn't pay for, technically.
Mm.
Wait, speaking of which.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you didn't.
Do it on the air.
Know, just hope I didn't, technically would have paid for it, but, like, I'm not going to regret it. Regret the time I spent.
Mm. Regret the time you spent.
Like, it was an
loves you lost.
You know, and enough of a good time for me to say it was worth coming out. And being here too.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. I think I'm pretty much in the same boat as you, Alejandro.
Just so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not as good as the first one. Now I mean I definitely disagree with a lot of the stuff I've been hearing about how awful it is.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like that thing you told me right before we went into the theater.
I think
that's a little extreme.
When I was told, and in case you missed it, because I believe you did, I had a friend
mm-hmm.
who saw it before because she works at a cinema.
Yeah.
And saw it and very, 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 very sternly told me mm-hmm. how much I should avoid it, as it was the most atrocious thing that they've seen. In the cinema in quite some time.
I honestly thought Mother was more atrocious than this movie.
Think
the action sequences, dude.
Yeah, the action sequences were definitely like just as good as the first one. Like
when they finally got
when
to
they,
them.
When they got to them, yeah.
Yeah.
When they got to them.
Yeah. But there was the memorable ones were, you know, there was I really liked when, you know, Eggsy and Harry get to Poppy Land and fucking shit up in Poppy
Land.
Oh
yeah, that's a dope
cool.
part. That, I mean, that's the big.
That's like the big
fight
one,
fight yeah. scene,
and then their fight with Whiskey at the end.
That was
the
cool.
three of them. That was
I like
cool.
the. I really like this, even though it was kind of small. It was Whiskey's like kind of highlight scene
mm-hmm.
outside of the cabin.
Yeah, it was cool.
Oh, that was
revolvers?
A yes.
Yeah,
that revolvers. Scene was dope.
Yeah.
They just like they have a really good eye. Who directs it?
Matthew Vaughn.
Matthew Vaughn. He directed the first one as well.
Yes, he did.
He just has a really good eye for, like, making these really cool aesthetic choices, especially throughout the whole film.
Yeah.
You know, and in, like, those really tight close-up shots that lead right into the next one.
Yeah.
It's very rhythmic.
Yeah, and how the fight scenes are shot with, like, it's very stylistic, but, like, the camera, yeah, it'll zoom in and then, like, zoom out and, like, whip around and stuff.
All panning and all
that. The camera matches how quick the fight is, which is cool.
Yeah. Julianne Moore. As Poppy,
yes,
she was great.
She was surprisingly good. Yeah, I she's great all around. You know, and I think I've seen her in most of the time. But when I first saw her introduced, I was like, really? And then
I thought she was a great villain.
Yeah.
No, and that's what it is. It turned out that she ended up being just very, very refreshing, actually, to me. Like, even though she kind of follows some stereotypical tropes of classic villainy, you know, she still felt refreshing and somewhat new. To the realm of these action movies that don't tend to have heavy female villains, you know,
mm-hmm.
I don't see them too often.
See,
they're not a usual thing.
One thing that was a little strange to me was like when she was describing her agenda.
Yeah,
I was like, why do I agree with you?
I know,
like,
the same thing.
I kind of think this is good. This would be a good thing to happen if.
Obviously, the way she went about it was very extreme.
Yes, but
was anyone else criticizing the president, or was I like the only other person?
Oh, yeah,
of course. I mean, he was a villain.
He was supposed to be.
He ended up being.
No, I meant like, was I the only other person? Like, kind of like, I kind of like your plan.
Who, the president?
Yeah, I don't know.
You like the president's plan?
Like, not so much his plan, but I was just like, I can see his where he's going.
No,
where he's going.
Stupid.
He was dumb
and everything about.
But it's appalling to me that you are like on his side with this.
It's not so much I was on his side. It's just maybe it's just more like a lack, like apathetic almost.
Okay, what?
Like, everyone was about to die over taking drugs, and yeah. I was just like, that's fine.
Maybe that says more about you than it does about his character in the movie.
It's very weird of you to say that.
Okay, I think
recreational drugs are fine. Okay, it's not like we haven't all taken part in recreational drugs.
So what are you saying?
What are you getting at here?
Saying that maybe I've just been dealing with too much crackheads lately, and it's getting to become.
Tell me what your latest crackhead experience is, Alejandro. Please tell me.
Oh my God.
What's the last time you hung out with a crackhead? And had a problem with them.
They just keep coming to the store. It's really. I think a big part of Julianne Moore's weakness as a character, as Poppy's weakness, is that she's just too stationary.
She's in that place the entire time.
Yeah,
right?
There's no sense of freedom with it.
I like her place. I think that was interesting and cool.
Yeah,
but they also. Her character, they do that a little bit with her character, where they like throw all these different things on her, but not as much, you know. Like they give her that whole like 1950s aesthetic.
And it's not as funny. It's not as ridiculous.
Nor is it as fully explored.
Yeah,
right.
It's brought up, but unlike Sam Jackson, we don't actually get to see much of it or feel much of it or see it in actual like play.
Yeah.
Because aside from it being the set of the 1950s. Mm. Did we really see anything else that played a part of that 1950s role?
Yeah, not really.
Nothing.
Not really. Just the visuals, I guess. Mm-hmm. But other stuff I did like was I liked that they killed off a lot of people. Like Merlin died, Roxy died. You know, she was a big character in the first one.
Yeah, the only thing, Channing Tatum was so underutilized.
Yes!
It's so frustrating.
Yes!
Why did they? They should have switched the roles and had Channing Tatum be Whiskey.
Yeah. I was so upset when I realized what was happening with that.
Yeah.
I was like, why would you do that? As
soon as they were going to put him away, you know, until they found some form of cure towards everything, I was like, oh, they're gonna bring him back in like 10 minutes.
Yeah, right.
Do something. Like, there's something here. There's something here. And
I think just my general... If I could think of one general problem with the movie as a whole, is that it was too long and too much fluff, like you were saying.
Way too much fluff.
They could have cut a lot and like really focused the movie more.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of stuff that didn't need to be in there.
I didn't care about his girlfriend and that plot went on for the whole movie.
Yep.
And it just kept going.
Yep. I chuckled at first when I saw that he was dating her.
Yeah.
From the first movie.
Yes.
I thought that was funny.
Yeah.
But then, it was too much.
I don't know. There was just like too many subplots that went on. There were too many scenes that went on too long.
The president stuff.
They didn't need to make the president a villain. It's just like.
Or even really necessary. Like one statement would have been fine. One statement to say whether he was going to help or not. And actually, the movie would have gone much smoother and tighter. If the president was just like, we don't negotiate terrorism and terrorists, and that just puts the statesman's whole thing as a bigger forefront of like why this needs to happen.
Yeah, and that just put in my brain, I was like, why? Okay, now I have to look at Julianne Moore as an evil character and the president as an evil character. You know, you're kind of subtracting from her.
And even more subtraction from her was Whiskey.
That's true. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They didn't need to do that either, I don't think.
And, like, his motivations and stuff were revealed so fucking quickly.
Yeah.
And it was like,
like that.
And all right.
Plus, you don't care. You don't care at all because you're given, like, the only exposition you're given on that is the flashbacks in the picture.
Yeah.
That's the only moment that you get.
Weak. And, was weak. You I was hoping much. That, like, because to me it was very obvious that he was, like helping out the Golden Circle or whatever. Yeah. But I was like, okay, they're going to reveal it in a way that's like, oh, it's been like that from the beginning. And then like you watch back and there's like things hinting at it as the movie goes on. But I was like, no. Yeah.
I think we might all agree on this as Elton John was overused.
Absolutely. The
Thank
joke
you.
Was fine at first.
Yes.
It was like, ha ha, Elton John, you're part of this. And then he's in it for like three more scenes.
He's in it a lot.
Yeah.
And they really milk that joke.
But However, Saturday Night's All Right for fighting scene was, and the use of that song was dope. I was very upset they didn't use My Generation like they did in the trailers.
Oh, yeah, they didn't do that.
But, yeah. You know.
We did, at first, when I saw that the first character, the first Golden Circle member who betrayed Julianne Moore was, like, eviscerated in the grinder.
Mm-hmm.
No blood, no nothing. All we saw was clothing being ripped
That's
up.
That's right, that was weird.
And, I think that was just some beef. I think that was a more of an aesthetic choice. I think so. I think they would have put in the blood. I don't think it was a matter of trying to pull a punch.
No, I agree. I don't think it was a pulling a punch move either, because it's rated R movie, and they did a lot of,
and they showed the fucking meat coming out. Yeah. I mean, that's gross enough to begin with.
I was just kind of like, oh, is this PG-13 for like a split second? Because I was like, is this PG-13? Because it's like, you know, of course I just saw fluffy clothes and then just meat, and I was expecting like. I was really ready for, like, visceral bone-crunching, like, just splintery blood just splattering everywhere.
I think I would have liked that better.
And then Julianne Moore having the nice, just, like, blood-covered hand or something, and just serves a nice, delicious burger. By the way, I did lean in and burn and was like, I want that burger.
it was a good-looking burger.
It was.
I think I agree, though, if it was, like, big blood splatter on her, and like, I would have been more into that.
Yeah, but, because of her, how it just shows how
crazy she is.
Yes, the psychopath inside of her, which everyone tried to hint at.
And then, like the fact that, like, when he had to put the tracking device on What's-Her-Face, hilarious concept, executed terribly. I think, like, with the whole having to call his girlfriend and tell her that...
I agree.
And then, like, I was like, this could have been hilarious. Yeah. It could have been hilarious, like, weird, awkward scene.
Yeah, where he was trying to, like...
Yeah. But no, it was, like, it was tainted with, I have to call the girlfriend that has this whole upsetting scene. And then, like, he doesn't bang the girl and he leaves, I'm in a relationship. And, like...
Yeah. It became, like... Like dramatic, like, yeah. Like it was sappy.
Such a lighthearted scene.
Yeah, it could have been hilarious. And also, I look back on it, I was like, yo, like, why did he even have to call her? Because like, he
clearly more important.
He called her and he told her, I might have to sleep with someone, you know,
like a target,
yeah. And I was like, you don't have to sleep with her. All you have to do is finger her.
Which is what he did. So, I mean, I'm sure, like, the moment, like, of the character, he obviously didn't think it could have been that simple.
Right.
But then it was that simple, and then there's no real harm done.
Right, he didn't even do anything.
Yeah.
So,
dude, I mean...
Only two of them.
So, I love Jeff Bridges, by the way.
Oh, same.
In this movie.
Give him some credit, too.
Jeff Bridges, dude. Yeah. Like, what a guy. Good. Like, champ. What a great guy. Champ. Oh, when he said that, he's like, I'm champagne. But everyone calls me champ. I was yes.
I love it.
And he's always drinking, and he's like sniffing the whiskey and stuff.
And like the cigar and stuff.
Yeah. Honestly, I wouldn't suggest anybody go to the theater to see it.
Yeah, nothing like that.
I would say just rent it from
that for you.
Yeah, exactly.
We did that for you. We went and we saw, we were okay with our experience.
You got that Amazon Fire Stick, just throw that baby up. Yeah.
Worth a watch.
Worth a Pirate Bay visit.
I get you.
All right.
A yiffy, you know?
Well, on that note.